You see, when you end up killing one of your men, you tell yourself it happened so you could save the lives of two or three or 10 others, maybe 100 others.
Parachuted in with the 101st Airborne right before the invasion. He's somewhere in Normandy. We don't know where.
Is he alive?
We don't know.
Some private in the 101st lost three brothers and he's got a ticket home. You and I are taking a squad over to Newville on a public relations mission.
My way, thank you, sir. This entire mission is a serious misallocation of valuable military resources.
I mean, where's the sense of risking the lives of the eight of us to save one guy? I swear, I hope Mama Ryan's real fucking happy knowing that little Jimmy's life is a little bit more important than two of our guys.
I don't know anything about Ryan. I don't care. The man means nothing to me. It's just a name. But if finding him so he can go home, if that brings me the right to get back to my wife, well then, that's my mission.
It doesn't make any sense, sir. Why? Why do I deserve to go? Why not any of these guys? They all fought just as hard as me.
They're supposed to tell your mother?
Tell her that when you found me, I was here, and I was with the only brothers that I have left. And there was no way I was going to desert.
What do you think?
You don't want to know what I think. What if by some miracle we stay and actually make it out of here? Someday we might look back on this and decide that saving Private Ryan was the one decent thing we were able to pull out of this whole god-awful shitty mess. That's what I was thinking, sir. Like you said, Captain, we do that, we all earn the right to go home.
This operation by heart and know his mission to the detail.
You're going to be jumping behind the enemy lines. What do you expect? You have no idea.
You think there's still hope, except the fact that you're already dead.
We all had fear, but we try to accomplish what you're supposed to be doing.
It's a feeling you would not let yourself down. And you would not let your comrades down.
I've seen death. My friends being killed.
Those events, you never forget them.
Changed dramatically.
We have affection that you get when you've lived through many dangerous situations together and have learned that you can rely on each other.
our special group. We found in one another a bond that exists only in combat.
My God. It's beautiful.
See the people today, that bond's still there, the bond you can't explain.
My grandson asked me the other day, Grandpa, were you a hero in the war? I said no, but I served in a company of heroes.
From this day to the ending of the world, we in it shall be remembered. We lucky few, we band of brothers.
Think it can't get worse, it can, and it will. The dying's not done, the killing's not done. I promised my crew a long time ago I'd keep them alive.
I was afraid you were dead. Where's the rest of 3rd Platoon?
We're it.
Sergeant Collier, I'm your new assistant driver.
Tank school? That's home.
Never even seen the inside of a tank.
You will. I started this war killing Germans in Africa. Now I'm killing Germans in Germany. Been with these fine gentlemen for years.
These troops get by you. We're all dead in the water. All we got is you.
I won't ask you to do anything I haven't done myself. Comm check.
Photo check.
Brady check.
Bond check.
Level check.
There! Bar!
All right!
Hit that son of a bitch! Hit him! Do your job! Do what you're here for!
The deals are peaceful. History is violent.
Wait till you see it.
See what?
What a man can do to another man.
I'm scared.
I'm scared too.
It will end soon. But before it does, a lot more people gotta die.
Well, you know, we do get $1.35 a day, right?
Best job I ever had.
Best job I ever had.
Best job I ever had.
They're coming.
How many?
300 of them. It's 5 against 300.
We never run before. Why are we gonna run now?
We're still in this fight.